Good morning, students of class 9. You are welcome back to the E classes. We are doing history now. Socialism in Europe. Socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. So this is the second after French Revolution. We are doing socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. In our previous class, we have learned about the age of social change. The age of social change. First, we are talking about European society. Later on, we'll learn about Russian Revolution. First, these all about socialism in Europe first, because it has an impact towards Russia. So now here 1.1, liberals, radicals, conservatives. So these three social groups, and today's date is 12th of May 2021. So now first we'll talk about liberals, and then we'll talk about radicals, and in our next class we'll talk about conservatives. So liberal, these are the various social groups in Europe. Number one, liberals. Number A, liberals. Who were the liberals? Liberals were the group of people who tried to follow the middle path, some old and some new changes. They want to follow some old system as well as adopt some new system. They were called the liberals. You can see by looking at these points, we will come to know. Liberals wanted a nation which tolerated all religions. They wanted a country or a nation where all religions were equally treated or tolerated. The nation tolerated all religions, means all religions were equally treated and people were allowed to follow any type of religion. So now here, liberals, they wanted some change model. Number B, during this period, we'll talk about, during this period, European states favor one religion or the other. European states, they favor one religion and discriminated another. They favored certain religions in European states. So this they want to change. Number B, C, liberals also oppose the uncontrolled power of the dynastic rulers. They also oppose that the uncontrolled power of the dynastic rulers who were Bourbon kings, aristocratic, you can say that, conservatives. So they oppose this uncontrolled power of the dynastic rulers. They also wanted to safeguard the right of the individual against government. So the government used to oppose or pressurize the people to follow their certain policies, but these liberals, they oppose that people have the right to choose, so people must be given the freedom to choose. So against the safeguard of the rights of the individual, they oppose against the government, these liberals. These are all modern, they wanted to adopt modernization. You can see, they argued for a representative elected government. They wanted that there should not be any kind of kings or monarchs. There should be a representative form of government subject to laws. The government will have to follow the constitution. Whoever are the leaders or representatives, they have to work according to the constitution, explained by well-trained judiciary. The judiciary will provide guidance, and it should be the government should follow the constitution, explained or you can say that interpreted by the well-trained judiciary that was independent of rulers and the officials. Judiciary will work independently. They will not work under the pressure of the government or the officials. They are independent, so to decide. So the government must follow the advice provided by the well-trained judiciary, and these are the modern changes liberals want. Now let's talk about certain old system they want to follow as well. They did not want to leave the old system. They did not believe in universal adult franchise. Franchise means vote. They did not want that all the people should get the voting rights, which was the in previously this system was there. They did not want to change this, the old system. They want to continue. They did not believe in universal. Universal means one to all adult franchise means both. They felt men a property. We have already learned in class 9 also, in our previous class also we have learned in French Revolution. They felt men of property mainly should have the right to vote. So in European society, the men of property were allowed to vote, but without property and wealth, people were not allowed to vote. We have already learned about that. And this old system, they want to continue. You see that? They did not want the vote for women as well. The women were not allowed to cast their vote. So this was the old system they want to follow, and these are the modern system they want to change. You see that they are following the middle path, certain old system and certain new system they want to follow. So these are the liberals. They wanted to take the middle path. Certain new changes and certain old system has to be followed. So now these are about the liberals. Now we'll talk about radicals. Radicals, certain groups of people who wanted total change. They wanted a total change. They were called radicals. Now let's talk about radicals. Number A, radicals wanted a nation. They wanted a nation in which government based on majority of a country's population. The country's population will cast a vote, and whichever party gets the majority of the vote, they will rule the government. They will rule the country. So the government based on majority of a country's population, they believe in that. Radicals, they believe. Means democratic way. Supported women's suffrage movement. Suffragette movement means they supported women for their voting rights. You see that, that the total radicals, total change they want. They oppose the privileges enjoyed by the landowners and the first class and second class in the European society. They oppose the privileges enjoyed by birth. So radicals, they want to change this also. And number C, they did not oppose private property. The private property they did not oppose, because this was introduced by Napoleon, because private property were protected during the rule of Napoleon. So they did not want to change. They did not oppose, radicals did not oppose private property, but dislike the concentration of wealth and property in the hands of few. They did not like that few people should concentrate all the wealth in the country. So they did not like this. They oppose private property, they did not oppose, but concentration of wealth and property in the hands of few, they did not like this. So these were the ideas of the radicals, their ideals and their policy. So we have learned about liberals and radicals. In our next class, we'll talk about conservatives, who wanted to restore the old system. Conservatives. So in our next class, we'll talk about conservatives. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and keep on studying. Go through this 1.1. Look at the title of the chapter, Socialism in Europe. Right now we are talking about this only. We have not reached Russian Revolution. We are talking about socialism in Europe. The European society was divided into various groups, various social groups. So socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. You go through that title and go through number 1.1, that is the subtitle, liberals, radicals and conservatives. You go through this first, don't read all everything at a time. You read first liberals and the second radicals, then you will understand. As you have watched, it will be much clearer. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class and continue our lesson in this chapter, conservatives. So thank you for watching.